Assalamu alaikum, students. I am Dr. Romana with your lecture on epithelium. It is actually the continuation of the previous lecture. So we will start with it. So as I know that you have done in your practical different types of cells, Dr. Zarin has made you see different types of cells under the microscope and how to draw them. So coming over to the type of epithelium, that is a simple, in the first diagram you see simple squamous epithelium. Then the second one is a simple cuboidal. They are composed of cuboidal cells. Then the columnar or the pyramid like cells, these are the simple columnar cells. Then coming over in the second line, you see that there are the multiple layer of the cell. That is called as a stratified squamous epithelium. Then in the next diagram you see stratified cuboidal cells epithelium, in which the cuboidal cells are lying just like small boxes, one on top of each. Then you see the columnar cells with different level of the nuclei, which is called as a pseudo stratified columnar epithelium. Then in the last slide you see that there is another type of arrangement of the cell, and that is called as the transitional epithelium, in which on the topmost layer, that is the apical layer, you see large dome shaped cells with the large nuclei in them. So that is the transitional epithelium. We'll be discussing each type of epithelium in detail later on. And I hope this lecture is clear to you. We have discussed what is tissue. Then we came over to what is the different types of tissue in our body. Then we have picked one of them, that is the epithelial tissue called as epithelium. Then we have studied and the definition of epithelium, the different classification of the epithelial tissue and different types of cells and the special types of cells which are present in it, the characteristic of the epithelium and the function of the epithelium. I've closed my lecture over here. In the next lecture we'll be discussing each of the cell in detail, type of epithelium along with its cell, its location in detail later in the next lecture. I hope it is clear. I will be giving you the assignment at the end of the lecture that you will have to complete, and you will have to send it on your BDS dissection WhatsApp group. There you will have to give me the assignment that I will mark your presence according to the assignment as I received after within 15 minutes of the end of the lecture. Otherwise you will be marked absent. I hope this lecture is clear to you. Thank you for listening. Starting with the classification of the epithelium, as we have studied in the previous lecture, that the type of the epithelium are divided into simple epithelium, which is further divided into simple squamous epithelium, as you can see in the diagram, then the simple cuboidal epithelium and the simple columnar epithelium. And then there is stratified epithelium, which is the stratified squamous epithelium, stratified cuboidal epithelium, stratified columnar epithelium, and another variety of the simple epithelium is actually the pseudo stratified columnar epithelium, as you can see in this diagram also. And then comes the special type of epithelium, which is the transitional epithelium, which is characteristic of the epithelium that lines the lower urinary system or the lower urinary tract. And the other name for it, if you can recall, is the uroepithelium. Now we will discuss each of the type of the epithelium in detail. The first one is the simple squamous epithelium. It is, as you can see in this diagram, that it is made up of simple squamous cells, which are the cells, as you have studied in your practical also, they are fusiform in shape with a central bulging portion and the tapering ends. And the simple squamous epithelium is actually comprising of the single layer of flat cells. The common examples of it are that it is lining when it lines the blood vessels. It is called as endothelium. When it lines the body cavities, like in the pleura or the pericardium, then it is called as mesothelium. It is very thin, and the most important function that occurs through this is that it controls the diffusion, osmosis and filtration. Continuing with the simple squamous epithelium, it is actually composed of flattened, irregularly shaped cells which form a continuous surface, and that's why they are referred as pavemented epithelium. And the term squamous is actually derived from the word that it resembles the scales on of the fish. जैसे फिश के ऊपर वो स्केल्स बने हुए होते हैं, उस तरह की एक एपिथेलियम जो है ये देता है अपीयरेंस. एक्चुअली यू नो दैट दीज सेल्स आर एक्चुअली पॉलीगोनल इन आउटलाइन, बट द फ्री सरफेस ऑफ ईच फ्लैट सेल विल बी फेसिंग टुवर्ड्स अ ल्यूमन, व्हाइल द अदर बेसल सरफेस विल बी रेस्टिंग ऑन विच स्ट्रक्चर, द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन. सो द सेल, दे हैव गॉट अ वेवी मार्जिन, and then they fit very closely to the next or the adjacent cell. When they are viewed from the top, they give an appearance, mosaic-like appearance. So, while when the sections are made perpendicular to the epithelial sheet, then they show that the individual cell has a fusiform or spindle-shaped appearance, because the central region of the cell is thicker due to the presence of nucleus, while periphery the cytoplasm is very thin. So you have drawn it in your diagrams, in your histology practical also, the shape of the simple squamous cell. So when you make a continuous line of it, that the cells are very lying close, very close to each other, so then they will be giving a pavemented epithelium appearance. They are supported by the underlying delicate membrane, and they are involved in the function of passive transport of either gases or fluids. So this will be the function. Coming over to the examples of the simple squamous epithelium, when they are lining the alveoli where the exchange of gases take place, they are called as mesothelium. They also are present in the kidney glomerulus, where filtration and diffusion take place. When they are the capillaries, the main function will be carrying out will be diffusion and osmosis. Mesothelium will be the lining which is that of the serous membrane, and all the vessels and the heart, their name changes to endothelium. So if somebody asks you that what is endothelium, so when the blood vessels and the heart, the lining of the simple squamous epithelium will be called as endothelium. When they will be lining the body cavities, like the pleura, the pericardium, the peritoneum, then they will be called as mesothelium. And in the lungs also, they are present in the alveoli, where gas exchange take place, so then there will be, the lining will be simple squamous epithelium. So I hope this is clear. We have studied the simple squamous epithelium, how it appears when viewed from the top, mosaic appearance, what are the type of cells? They are the simple squamous cells. Then what is the shape of the simple squamous cell? I've told you they are fusiform or spindle shaped with the central bulging portion and the tapering periphery. And then I've told you the other names for the simple squamous epithelium, when they are lining the vessels, when they are lining the capillaries, when they are lining the body cavities and in the kidney. And what will be the main function? Simple function of gas exchange and filtration. This will complete the simple squamous epithelium. Now coming over to the next one. Now the second type of simple epithelium that we are going to discuss is the simple cuboidal epithelium. This variety of the, from this diagram, as you can see that they are made up of cuboidal cells, as you have studied in your practical. When we observe the section which is made perpendicular to the epithelial sheet, the cells, they have got a roughly cuboid appearance. That is, the length and the breadth is equal with a centrally placed nucleus, as you can see in this diagram. But when we have a view from the surface, the epithelium shows that the cells are rather hexagonal or polygonal in shape. But because of the closely fitting of these cells, they are actually forming a cuboidal appearance. You can see that their free surface is towards the lumen, and then the they are lying on the basement membrane. So from this diagram, the shape of the cell is clear that they are cuboidal in shape. The cells are cuboidal in shape. Again, as a repetition, this epithelium consists of single layer of closely opposed cells. Closely opposed, which type of cell? Cuboid cells. The cells which are square in nature, the height and the width of each cell appears to be nearly equal. And each cell is containing a centrally placed spherical nucleus. Now, actually the simple cuboidal epithelium has a very restricted distribution in the body. So you should be knowing its example very clearly. They are actually present in the small excretory ducts of the exocrine glands and intercalated ducts of the salivary gland and in the pancreas, and number two, in the lining of the distal convoluted tubules and in the outer surface of the ovary. So you should remember these three examples for the simple cuboidal epithelium. Now, coming over to the third variety, which is included in the simple columnar epithelium. This type of epithelium consists of single layer of tall column-shaped cells with oval nuclei towards the basal part, and the main function is exchange take place, and the examples that they are present, they are very markedly distributed in the body and widely distributed in the body, and they are lining the internal surface of stomach, intestine, gallbladder and uterus. Okay, the simple columnar epithelium is actually composed of column-shaped cells. You have studied in your practical also how to draw these column-shaped cells. On the surface, the cell appears the mosaic, but mosaic-like appearance, just like the cuboidal cell, but they are very closely packed to each other. But in the perpendicular section, the columnar shape of the cells become very much clear, in which the height of the cell is much greater than its width, and the nucleus is commonly oval in shape and it is located near the base of the cell. So the nuclei of the cells of the sheet of the simple columnar cell are often seen to be situated roughly at the same level. Now you should be knowing the examples. They are actually lining the internal surface of stomach, intestine, gallbladder and uterus. But you should also remember that in many locations of the body, the cells of the simple columnar epithelium shows surface modification that I am going to teach you in my next lecture. That is the surface modification on their apical surface. That is the surface which is be facing towards the lumen. And they include microvilli, kinocilia and sterocilia. That we are going to study in detail in the next lecture. Now we will discuss a special category of the simple epithelium. That is actually the simple epithelium, but it is the modification of columnar epithelium. All the cells the columnar cells are resting on the basement membrane, but only the tall ones, they reach towards the lumen, while the basal cell, they do not reach the surface and they are present between the columnar cells. And the nuclei are present at variable levels, so they give the appearance, false appearance of the stratified epithelium. Usually, this is asked in your viva also, why they are called a pseudo-stratified epithelium. Pseudo means giving a false, stratified means multi-layer appearance. So the the examiners usually ask that why do we call them pseudo-stratified epithelium? They are therefore the position of the nuclei is responsible for giving it a stratified appearance. Again discussing it, this is actually the modification of simple columnar epithelium. The nuclei of the cell, they are present at different level, so they give the false appearance of being stratified, that is multilayered. But all the cells, they are lying on the basement membrane. Only the tall ones will be able to reach towards the surface. But the other cells, which are called as the basal cell, they are lying in between the columnar cells. These cells are small in size. However, they are conical in shape, but they do not reach the free surface. The nuclei are found to be aligned at two or more levels in the epithelium. Therefore, they create a false stratified appearance. Now, the examples are usually they are lining the conducting part of the respiratory system. And the conducting part of the respiratory system includes nose, nasopharynx, trachea and bronchi. While they are also lining the major male genital ducts, that is the duct of the epididymis and ductus deferens. In this diagram, as you can see that the pseudo-stratified cell are composed of large columnar cells, their nuclei are at a higher level as compared to those which are present in between these tall columnar cell are the short conical shaped cell, their nuclei towards the basal surface. So they are giving the false appearance that they are multilayered, but all the cells are resting on the basement membrane, as you can see. So, but their conical surface, that is the apical surface of the tall one, is reaching towards the lumen, while the basal surface of all of them is resting on the basement membrane. This is the microscopic appearance of trachea, in which you can see that in between the coming over towards the epithelium, you can see that they are the pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Can you appreciate the levels of the nuclei? Some are at the higher level, some of them they are at the lower level, but all of these cells are resting on the basement membrane. So this is a pseudo stratified ciliated columnar epithelium as it appears under the microscope. Again, just to explain the examples, I have written that they are location is in the trachea, bronchial tree, and ductus deferens and epididymis. And while when they are present in the trachea, bronchial tree, and ductus deferens, their main function is secretion, and they act as a conducting pathway. And when they are present in the ductules of epididymis, their main function is absorption of the seminal fluid and as the conducting pathway for the sperms. We have done in detail the simple epithelium. Now coming over to the stratified multilaminar epithelium. These epithelium consist of two or more layers of cell, in which only the lowest most cell, that is the bottom layer, will be resting on the basement membrane. The stratified, and they are classified into their subtype according to the type of cells which are present in the superficial layer, that is the layer on the surface of the epithelium. They will be named according to that epithelium. आपको क्लियर हुआ है कि जो स्ट्रेटिफाइड मल्टी लेमिनर एपिथेलियम की जब हम बात करते हैं तो उसमें एक से ज्यादा लेयर्स ऑफ सेल प्रेजेंट हैं, और जो सबसे नीचे वाली लेयर है दैट विल बी रेस्टिंग ऑन द बेसमेंट मेम्ब्रेन, बाकी उसके ऊपर 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 करते करते सरफेस तक आ जाएंगे. लेकिन जो नाम है एपिथेलियम का, स्ट्रेटिफाइड एपिथेलियम का, वो नाम उसके जो सेल का लेयर ऊपर की तरफ टुवर्ड्स द सरफेस या टुवर्ड्स द सुपरफिशियल लेयर होगा, दैट लेयर विल बी द सरफेस एपिथेलियम एंड दे विल बी नेम्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट लेयर. सो कमिंग ओवर टू द फर्स्ट वन इज द स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्क्वेमस एपिथेलियम. दिस वैरायटी विल बी प्रेजेंट ऑन दो सरफेस व्हिच आर सब्जेक्टेड टू वेयर एंड टियर. जो उसका द बेसल लेयर is made up of cuboidal or low columnar cell that will be resting on the basement membrane. On top of the basal layer, you will see few layers of large polygonal cell, and then towards the free surface, the cell become flattened and they are squamous. Then they are called as the squamous type of cells, and when the topmost contains keratin in them, that will be the keratinized epithelium. That will be more clear to you in the next slide. So coming over to the sub variety of the stratified squamous epithelium, it is the epithelium which is present in the skin is keratinized, and the example is epidermis, while the non keratinized stratified squamous epithelium is present in the oropharynx, esophagus and vagina. इजी तरीका आपको याद रखने के लिए ये है कि जो भी एरिया आपका सरफेस की तरफ या एक्सटीरियरली जो है वो एक्सपोज्ड है बाहर की एरियाज, बाहर की सरफेस से, तो दैट विल बी लाइन बाय द स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्क्वेमस एपिथेलियम. अब वो कैरेटिनाइज्ड है या नॉन कैरेटिनाइज्ड है, वो कैरेटिनाइज्ड है सिर्फ एपिडर्मिस में, जबकि वो नॉन कैरेटिनाइज्ड है ओरोफेरिंक्स में, फिर इसोफेगस में और विजाइना में. ये सारी सर्फेसेस आपकी बॉडी की आउटसाइड एनवायरनमेंट से एक्सपोज होती हैं. इसी तरह कॉर्निया में भी स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्क्वेमस एपिथेलियम इज प्रेजेंट. आंख भी बाहर की तरफ हो रही है, इसोफेगस भी मुंह के अंदर खुल रहा है, विजाइना भी एक्सटीरियर को एक्सपोज हो रही है एनवायरनमेंट को, तो वहां पे सारा आपका प्रोटेक्टिव लेयर, जहां पे वेयर एंड टियर हो रही है और प्रोटेक्टेड लेयर चाहिए आपको, वहां पे आपका स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्क्वेमस एपिथेलियम आएगा. आई होप इट इज क्लियर. सो कमिंग ओवर टू इन दिस स्लाइड यू कैन सी दैट द स्ट्रेटिफाइड स्क्वेमस नॉन कैरेटिनाइज्ड एपिथेलियम, दैट इज द टॉप मोस्ट लेयर विल बी हैविंग विच टाइप ऑफ सेल्स, दे विल बी हैविंग स्क्वेमस सेल्स. And they have got flattened nucleus. The squamous cells will be having flattened nucleus. and they are present in the mouth, epiglottis, esophagus, vocal cords, vagina, and they are actually the moist superficial cells, and they are living cells. While in the keratinized one, the topmost layer will be the dead cells. They will be devoid of nuclei, and the main function over here is protection and secretion. Now, in this diagram, on the right side, you can see the stratified squamous keratinized epithelium. So, on the basal layer are the cuboidal cell or the basal cell. Then there are two layers of polygonal cells. And in the epidermis, then you can recall from your first year that what will be this stratum called as. Then on the top of them, they are the squamous cells and the topmost layer, which is devoid of any nuclei. The squamous cell are only showing pink staining, eosinophilic staining. So these are the keratinized cells, which are the dead cell, which will be the most lying in the most superficial layer. While on the left side, the diagram is showing on the basement membrane are present the basal layer, then again the polygonal cells. And then as we move towards the top layer, we see that they are made up of squamous cells, which are containing a flattened nuclei in the center, and these are therefore living cells. And you should know the difference that where the non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium is present in the body and where the keratinized epithelium is present. Now, coming over to the second variety of the multilaminar layer is the stratified cuboidal epithelium. As it is clear from the name that the stratified cuboidal epithelium will consist of two or more layers of cuboidal cells. While this type of epithelium has a restricted distribution in the human body, actually they are lining the larger ducts of some of the exocrine glands. And the exocrine glands include the pancreas, salivary glands, and sweat glands. The main function of the stratified cuboidal epithelium is that they provide the duct with a stronger lining, which is more stronger than the simple cuboidal or columnar epithelium. Now, coming over to the third variety of the stratified epithelium is the stratified columnar epithelium. This epithelium consists of columnar surface cells, which are resting on one or more layer of roughly cuboidal cells. It has also got a restricted distribution in the body, and the example is it is only present in the conjunctiva of the eye. I will show you how it appears under the microscope and how you will have to draw them. On the left side, you can see that this is how the microscopic appearance of the stratified columnar epithelium looks like. On the basement membrane, you can see that there are the cuboidal cells layer, one or two, and on the top of them is the columnar cell. And this is the appearance. The lower cells are showing the cuboidal cells, and on top of them are present the columnar cell with the basal nuclei. So the columnar cells, one or two layer, will be resting on the basal layer of the cuboidal epithelium. So the surface epithelium in case of conjunctiva of the eye will be lined by the columnar cells. So this epithelium will be called as stratified columnar epithelium. Transitional epithelium is also a special type of stratified epithelium that is actually lining the lower urinary tract. This epithelium is also called as uroepithelium, and functionally it accommodates well to the function of distension. The lower urinary tract extends from the minor calyces of the kidney down to the proximal part of the urethra. So this is the area of its distribution. The transitional epithelium can be best studied in the microscopic picture of walls of the urinary bladder, and the microscopic structure of this type of special type of multilaminar epithelium varies greatly according to the state of distension of the urinary bladder. That is, in the undistended urinary bladder and the distended urinary bladder. We will study the layers in detail now. So, in undistended bladder, that is the relaxed bladder, the uroepithelium consists of 6 to 8 layers of cells. Starting from the basal layer, which is cuboidal cell. Above it, there are 5 to 6 layers of polygonal cells. Then the superficial cell, they consist of large dome-shaped cells, which are called as umbrella cells. Some of these umbrella cells, they have got more than one nuclei. And it is because of its highly mitotic activity that they contain more nuclei, more than one nuclei in them. So, that is the structure in the undistended bladder. Now, the difference of the transitional epithelium in the distended bladder, that is the stretched bladder, is that the transitional epithelium consists of 2 to 3 layers. Now, the basal layer will be the same, that it is made up of cuboidal cell. Above them, instead of 5 to 6 layers of polygonal cell, only about 1 or 2 layer of polygonal cell, and on the top of them will be the flat squamous cells. The flat squamous cells are actually the dome shaped cells. They are stretched and they take up the appearance of the squamous cells. While the thing that is to be noted is that the cells in the basal layer are not much affected, but cells in the upper 2 or 3 layers, they are affected and they are stretched to give the flat squamous appearance instead of the dome-shaped appearance in the undistended bladder. This transitional epithelium is actually performing the barrier function. The urine cannot enter the bladder wall because of 2 reasons. This is usually asked in your viva also, that what is the barrier function, why doesn't the urine spill out of the bladder wall? It is because that the cell membrane of these dome-shaped cells are totally impermeable to salt and water. And moreover, these cells have got very tight junctions which prevent leakage. And these junctions are zonula occludens and desmosomes. The cell junction lecture will be taken later on, which will make this barrier function more clear to you. But you should be knowing that what is the importance of this dome-shaped cell and how they are performing the barrier function. The dome-shaped cells in the superficial layer, they unfold the plasma membrane to increase the surface area. The folding and unfolding of the plasma membrane increases or decreases the surface area. In the next slide, you will see the microscopic appearance of the transitional epithelium. In this microscopic picture of the transitional epithelium, you can see that the dark line is actually the basement membrane on which are resting the cuboidal cell, then the polygonal cell layer you can see, and on top of them there is the dome shaped cells with 1 or 2 nuclei in them, and this basement membrane is followed by the lamina propria. So this is how the transitional epithelium appears under the microscope when we see the section of urinary bladder. So, as I have told you, that the transitional epithelium is present in the lower urinary system, and when it is present in the renal calyces, it is carrying out the barrier function. When it is present in the ureters, bladder and the urethra, then it, in addition to the barrier function, distensible properties also added to it. That is, the dome-shaped cell or the layers of the cells in the superficial layer, they stretch out to distend that particular viscera. Only small thing that is left with today's lecture is that it consists that we have to discuss two special varieties of epithelial cells. When I told you the classification, I mentioned the name of neuroepithelial cells and the myoepithelial cells. So the neuroepithelial cells, these are the tall columnar cells which bear microvilli, cilia or stereocilia on their free surface. As you can see that the neuroepithelial cells are present in the special sense organs like taste buds and the vestibulocochlear receptor system of the internal ear. You can see in the diagram on the left side, which is showing the structure of the taste bud. And they have got nerve fibers which are ending in few of the tall columnar cells, and these cells are actually the neuroepithelial cells. While in the diagram on the right side, you can see that there are the secretory acini in the salivary gland, in which you can see few of the smooth muscle cells which are surrounding these acini. These are called as the myoepithelial cells, and these cells are actually star-shaped cells, and they have many processes. Their cytoplasm contains actin and myosin, and these cells contract when stimulated by neural or the neurohumoral signals. So they are found around the secretory acini of the mammary gland, salivary gland, lacrimal gland and sweat glands. So this completes our lecture on the epithelium. Now, the assignment for you is that you have to write down the type of the epithelium along with the examples. That is, starting from the simple squamous epithelium, write the heading simple squamous epithelium and then give its examples. Then the simple cuboidal epithelium and its examples. Similarly, you will have to write all of these name of the epithelium along with their examples. This completes your lecture on the epithelium. We will be doing the surface modifications in our next lecture. Listen to the lecture first, and then within the last 10 minutes or 15 minutes, complete your assignment and send it to me on your WhatsApp group for the histology, for the dissection. I hope that is made. Your attendance will be marked according to the assignment, and write down your name and roll number clearly on the top of your assignment. Thank you. It should be completed within your lecture time. Then only I will mark your attendance. Thank you.